and welcome to a special edition of ITV News West Country from a very muddy Glastonbury festival. Tonight's main stories. Torrential rain on the world's biggest festival site means one thing, mud. We'll have the latest on how people are battling the elements as the Met Office warns of more heavy rain to come.
Yeah, we call it Mount Kilimanjaro. It's fairly difficult. You slide down the tent.
Plus, when the music stops, we take a look at the places people lay their heads, from the sea of tents to the luxurious pop-up hotel. And it's not just the festival goers who have to face the wet weather. Dolly Parton tells us her mud tactics.
I'll probably wear my galoshes up to the stage with my high heels in them, and I'll probably take those off, but I'm going to sing in my high heels, mud or no mud.
And I'm also live at the Glastonbury Festival ahead of a very big weekend in the region. So what's the weather got in store? Stay tuned for those details.
And I'll have the rest of the day's news, including the very latest on the Cheltenham Banksy. The mystery has deepened today. So is it staying in the town or not?
And welcome to the Glastonbury Festival 2014. Now, the thing that everyone has been talking about today is, of course, the weather. Now, we've had a bit of everything today, I have to say. Sunshine, showers, some very heavy rain this morning, but that really hasn't put off festival goers. They have had to trudge through the mud a little bit, but that certainly hasn't dampened the atmosphere. It has been a lovely day indeed. Now, let's just give you a few facts and figures about the festival. This is a huge site, 1,200 acres, and 175,000 people will be here over the weekend for this, the biggest greenfield festival in the world. Now, this weekend, more than 2,000 acts will perform over 100 stages. And of course, on the site, we normally have 400 cows, but you'll be very pleased to hear they are safely away from the action. Now, the police have told us today that crime here is actually down at 30% already on last year. But it has been confirmed that one man has died from taking ketamine. Our Somerset correspondent reports now on the ups and downs of the festival so far.
Several weeks of superb weather had to finish sometime. And after all, those festival tents needed to be put through their paces too. Space was clearly a bit of an issue for this camper.
Yeah, we call it Mount Kilimanjaro. It's fairly difficult. You slide down the tent.
Did you get any sleep in there at all?
No, it was more the noise though than the angle. You just sort of learn to live with it. You sleep at the bottom.
So you just bunched up against the zip?
Yeah.
So if the zip goes, that's it, you're out.
We're going to slide out, we're going to end up down there.
Michael Evis says that festival rain is character forming, and to be frank, characters have been forming left, right and centre today. Take these four characters. Getting a good viewing spot in front of the pyramid stage is important, but they were taking it to extremes, sitting in the rain 90 minutes before a largely unknown Japanese band were due to start proceedings. The early bird gets the worm. Which worm are you waiting for?
We always come for the first band on the pyramid stage, and what are they called?
Turtle Island.
Turtle Island, yeah, we're here to see them.
Japanese band.
Never heard of them.
Turtle Island, Japanese band, in the rain for this band you've never really heard of.
Yeah, we're dedicated.
Yeah, show me what size like.
Nine. For this welly seller, there was a silver lining to the clouds. Rain always makes people eat more too.
No horse in the pasties, is there?
No. No horse being in the pasties here. Don't have the lasagna.
And the cider bus team, well, they were just dancing through the downpour. Meanwhile, police say crime at the festival is down 30%. It's mostly been thefts and drugs offences. They managed to track one stolen mobile phone to a tent.
Using some tracking equipment, we managed to track that phone to a tent where a lady was arrested. And as part of that arrest, she was also found in possession of drugs and arrested for that as well.
What a difference a day makes. In sunnier times, this man was sweltering inside a penguin suit, meeting up with 14 others.
We're going to be over by the cider bar. There should be about 15 of us.
And why penguins?
Why not?
Hopefully they can spray those fluffy suits with waterproofer. David Woodland, ITV News, Glastonbury Festival.
Well, I have to say, we are just dodging a very nasty looking storm. Alex is with me now. We've done all right today, haven't we?
Yeah, but this afternoon's been really good.
This morning was horrible.
Lovely spells of sunshine. This morning we had a pretty muddy situation. There was a lot of rain around. In fact, let's take a look at the rainfall situation over the last 24 hours. And you can see what caused the mud down on the main site. We saw a band of rain come through yesterday. That was quite heavy. And then through the overnight period into today, we saw heavy showers developing, a convergence line forming. So it was pretty dismal earlier, but at the moment we are doing really well because behind us it looks pretty good. You can see some bright skies, but just to the west of us where the Glastonbury Tor is, we are seeing some heavy rain developing, and I did actually see a bit of lightning developing.
We're just about
dodging it, so hopefully it will stay dry for us whilst we're on air.
Alex, thanks very much. We'll have the weather forecast a bit later in the programme, of course. Now, this year the Glastonbury Festival has banned what they call legal highs. These kind of mimic the effects of drugs like ketamine. There has been an 80% increase in people dying from taking legal highs, as Laura Macon Isherwood now reports.
People have been using drugs for centuries, at points even taking freely those Class A's that have now been outlawed. But even with legislation, finding euphoria in the UK isn't difficult.
It was a friend of mine and he'd bought it off the internet, and we were out on a night out, and yeah, he told me that it was good and I should try it. It was sort of the rush of taking MDMA with the like adrenaline of taking cocaine. All it takes is one Google search and you're there.
Ben is one of thousands to have tried over-the-counter highs, powders and pills designed to mimic the effects of harder drugs. But last year, the number of deaths linked to taking these new psychoactive substances rose 80%. And experts say trying them is like dancing in a minefield.
So it doesn't matter what it says on the packet, you don't know what's in it, and you are taking a risk. And with legal highs, the added risk is that you are the guinea pig. No one has trialled these substances on humans. The guinea pigs, the people that conduct the trial, is the customer.
Here at Glastonbury, little sign. Traders are banned from selling them, and the festival has joined a national campaign to raise public awareness.
I think the terminology itself is unhelpful because people do equate legality with safety, but the statistics speak for themselves. They're constantly evolving and using loopholes in the law to stay on the market, which is the internet or the high street.
I wouldn't say that just because your friend has tried it a few times that makes it safe, because it doesn't make it safe. The negative effect can take quite a while to come out, but once you become paranoid and you're feeling that problem with psychosis, then there's not really a lot you can do from there.
And with those warnings, many hope that the temptation to experiment will waver. Laura Macon Isherwood, ITV News, Glastonbury Festival.
Now everyone around me is putting on their waterproofs. I hope I don't need my hood anytime soon. Now, when you're walking around this site, you see all sorts of food outlets, pretty much anything you can imagine. You can probably see some of those now. That's just a fraction of what's on offer. And also there's plenty of local food producers set here that's said to be worth millions to the local economy, as Bob Cruz now reports.
You can't enjoy the festival on an empty stomach, and when it comes to food at Glastonbury, you're spoiled for choice.
This place is fantastic. We've got goat's cheese, caramelised onions, rocket salad with ham.
I've gone for the bison burger.
Local bison?
I don't think they roam locally. I haven't seen any around. No, that could be because they'll be farmed, I'm not sure. But yeah, tasty bison.
This is the backstage area of the West Holtz stage, and there are hundreds of people back here who need feeding too. Lighting technicians, stagehands, sound engineers, and of course the crew for the performers too. And they all sit down together, hundreds of them at a time, for three meals a day. The food behind the stage is all prepared by local Somerset caterer Caroline Gent, who spends months at home preparing for the festival around her wedding catering commitments. And there's lots of planning to do. She'll serve 11,500 meals over the 5 days, and she feeds the performers too.
We've got Brian Ferry this year, and we've had The Streets, we've had Black Eyed Peas, we've had Kool and the Gang, who are fabulous guys. And Celia Green on site suddenly said, oh, I've forgotten, I need cider vinegar. And so I had to go out on site and find that. And it had to be organic. And luckily I managed to buy a big drum of it. and he only wanted a couple of teaspoons, only a little bit. And my horse ended up, who's got arthritis, ended up drinking it all winter. I give it to him and say, you realise this is Celia Greens?
Plenty of space is set aside for local producers among the 250 food stalls on site. For some, the festival is what sustains them.
We get to run the club every year, cost-wise. It keeps us going, and we're very grateful to Michael for helping us out. It covers our running costs for the year. It's a lifeline.
Sometimes people say that we're out their main food for the weekend. You know, they come for lunch and dinner and then the next day and then the next day. And we get people that remember us because we've been here for the last 3 years now.
Whatever food takes your fancy at the festival, it's all here. A 24-hour feast on the farm. Bob Cruz, ITV News, Glastonbury Festival.
And you pretty much, honestly, can get anything you want here. It is amazing. Now, you can see behind me the sea of tents rolling down the hill toward the pyramid stage. And this is just a fraction of the tents that you'll see here. There are so many people camping here. But there are some other options if you want just a little bit of luxury, as I've been finding out.
When the sun goes down, Glastonbury wakes up. The population of a small city is gathered in these fields, and after dark, the party really begins. But what happens when those stages fall silent? Well, even the craziest of partygoers need a place to rest their heads. And although most opt for the simple tent, it's luxury camping that's now big business.
And just a few fields over from those packed-in tents, you'll find this, a caravan site that gets completely booked up as soon as Glastonbury tickets go on sale. And this is my van, affectionately known as Gertrude.
Unsurprisingly, this is the busiest time of year for the site.
Most people are really organised, and this year I was fully booked by March. It's usually people that have done the festival before and done the camping up there, still want to do the festival experience, but wants to have a bit more space and a bit more peace and quiet when they're away from it. I think one of the main pulls is that we've got proper toilets.
It certainly doesn't cost the earth to stay here, and this isn't the most luxurious option by any means. You still have to pitch a tent, of course, or bring your own caravan.
But if you want someone to do all the work for you, then this pop-up hotel might just be what you're looking for. Come and look at this. This is an amazing huge tent with 4 bedrooms and ensuite bathrooms.
For 8 people, it costs £10,000 for the Glastonbury weekend. This is the most expensive option here. There are the cheaper bell tents. But just who forks out for this level of luxury?
Well, a wide range, actually. There's quite a large diversity. Generally not very young. The younger kids are probably in Glasgow and they're you know, right in the midst of it all. But I think we probably appeal to a slightly older group that love to party still, but they just like to come back and relax somewhere and recharge their batteries for a while and get some good service and some good food and get raring to go again the next day.
You, of course, have a little walk to the main site. These luxury options are a few fields away from all the action. But if you still want a bit of pampering and can't stretch to pop-up luxury, then for £59 for the weekend here at the Powder Room, you can have a nice shower and somewhere to, well, powder your nose.
We find, you know, especially at Glastonbury, 75% of our customers are women, but it's also people who come into the end of their 20s, who've done the festivals, and they actually feel, oh God, I would like to have a shower. And they've got makeup girls to look after people, to really make themselves feel festival fresh and look after themselves.
But many see Glastonbury as a place to let their hair down. And for those thousands in tents without the little luxuries, they're still ready for more festival fun when the sun comes up.
Well, I'm in one of the camping fields now, which is, of course, where the majority of people choose to stay. And here are Ellie and Ryan. You're from Bristol, guys. Yeah. Your tent's looking beautifully clean. How are you keeping it like this in all this rain?
No wellies. You're not allowed in if you've got wellies on.
What was it like last night?
Last night was fine. This one's a new tent, so we're quite dry. Our old one last year, we had pots and pans out everywhere covering all the floods.
What are you looking forward to over the next couple of days?
I'm looking forward to Ed Sheeran. He's probably my favourite band. I'm looking for Arcadia in the night.
Brilliant.
Should be good.
I hope you managed to stay dry. Thanks very much, guys. Well, that's all from me for now. Make sure you join me later in the programme when we'll have an interview with the country and western queen herself, Dolly Parton.
Kylie, thank you very much. Good evening to you. A man in his 60s has been brutally murdered in Wiltshire. Police say his body was found just before midnight next to a cycle track in the centre of Swindon. He'd been repeatedly stabbed. Bob Constantine reports.
The cycle track where the man's body was found was today taped off as police began hunting a murderer. The dead man, who was in his 60s and lived locally, had been repeatedly stabbed. He was found just before midnight next to a path that runs under the railway line between Swindon Station and the Oasis Leisure Centre. A bike was found nearby.
It is an extremely vicious attack that has taken place overnight. We're currently exploring a number of lines of inquiries and we're really appealing to the public to help us find the person responsible. There is a possibility that the offender, male or female, could have blood on their clothing. And certainly their behaviour, either last night or today, could have changed somewhat after what has happened.
The scene of the crime is right in the heart of Swindon. People were shocked to learn of it today.
The fact that they've gone for someone who's that age and attacked him in such a vicious manner is pretty shocking, yeah.
It's incredible, really, to think that it could happen so close to the centre of Swindon and to have a murder. It's just unbelievable, really.
This underpass is normally fairly busy and police are now appealing for witnesses who may have been in this area last night and able to shed some light on what happened here. They say the man suffered stab wounds over his entire body and are now looking both for a murder weapon and a possible motive. One clue might lie in CCTV cameras in the area.
As you get into town, CCTV cameras do emerge. It's quite a wide open area, so there is a possibility of a number of exit points that the offender could have used. So we're building a strategy today to capture as much CCTV imagery as we possibly can and then start to work through it.
Police assume the man was out cycling, probably just after dark, when the attacker struck. Quite why is a mystery. Bob Constantine, ITV News, Swindon.
Proposals for a raised road in the flood-prone Somerset village of Muchelney will be shown to the community next week. Somerset County Council wants to raise part of Drayton Road by 60 centimetres. It's hoped this should maintain access to the village if it's flooded again. The event is in the village church next Thursday from 3 p.m. A fire which completely gutted an historic pub near Ashton Court in Bristol was started accidentally. Crews were called to the Dovecot pub in the early hours of yesterday morning. More than 50 firefighters and 9 fire engines attended. 80% of the 17th century building has been completely destroyed. Plans to cover some of Gloucester's least attractive buildings in decorative cladding have been approved by the City Council. The idea is to smarten up the city before it hosts the Rugby World Cup next year. Cheltenham's only Banksy has been sold to a private collector from London. The artwork appeared in April but was only confirmed as an original Banksy a couple of weeks ago. Well, now the building it's on is covered in scaffold and that has prompted the local council to threaten legal action. Jonty Messer reports.
When Banksy admitted a little earlier this month that Spy Booth on Hewlett Road was his handiwork, excitement soon turned to fear as people realised they suddenly had a hugely desirable piece of artwork in the town.
Yeah, I got a call on Wednesday from one of my members of staff saying that they were messing about with the Banksy, some builders were putting up scaffolding. It'd be a shame if it goes. I mean, it looks like it's going now.
The appearance of that scaffolding has prompted the council to get involved because the building is in fact listed, meaning any work needs approval before it can be carried out.
My understanding is that a letter's gone to the contractor to say that if any of the fabric is removed or damaged, it would need listed building consent and any work carried out would itself be illegal.
Another determined to keep Banksy in Cheltenham is Sarah White, who's been making calls from the phone box since 9 o'clock this morning to try and prevent work taking place.
Well, I came in here and I just feel like
raising awareness of the removal of this piece. I know there's probably nothing I can do about it because I was quite naive into thinking that it would stay here forever in Cheltenham.
As is often the case, it's money that talks loudest, and attempts are underway to try and raise the money needed to keep the artwork in Cheltenham.
We are talking the excess of £1 million, but we do believe that there's enough people that are passionate about this as being an important part of Cheltenham that will pledge the money. So we do believe we can raise the money.
It said Spy Booth is a nod to GCHQ and what goes on behind its walls. People now, though, are wondering what's happening behind this scaffolding to the town's one and only Banksy. John T. Messer, ITV News, Cheltenham.
Well, that is it from me in the studio for this evening. Let's cross back now to the Glastonbury Festival and rejoin Kylie. I can see, Kylie, you're still managing to stay dry.
Yeah, just about, Ian, but the storm is moving in. I'm hoping the wind is going to take it over us, but to be honest, it is a little bit chilly. Now, that music you can hear is coming from down there at the pyramid stage, the main stage here at Glastonbury. And on Sunday, it is very exciting indeed, because the country and western legend herself, Dolly Parton, will be performing here. Now, would you believe this? She's 68 years old and she's written more than 3,000 songs. She is amazing. Now, we managed to catch up with her in Tennessee and asked her what she's excited about the festival.
Oh, I'm so excited about that. Everybody's trying to scare me to death. I'm not scared. I've seen a lot of people before, but I'm really happy that that worked out where we could play the festival.
How did it come about?
Well, actually, I don't know. We were actually planning to go over there, and I think they had contacted us before to be there, and it wasn't where we could just go there just to do that because of so many things going on. So the fact that we were going to be going to Europe, somehow I guess the promoters and my manager all got together, and so that's how it happened, and I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, working 9 to 5.
There's a lot of mud, a lot of dust, but then that's not really new to you, is it?
No, I grew up in a mud hole. I grew up on a farm, worse stuff than mud that we had to walk around at in the barnyard. So anyway, so we were used to all that. They let you dream just to watch them shatter. You're just to step on the boss man's ladder, but you
got dreams he'll never take away. Now, in terms of what you're going to wear then, I mean, have you got special stiletto, you know, Wellington boots? What have you got for us?
Well, now, I won't be in the mud, will I?
Well, you may at some point.
Well, you think, well, I'll probably wear my galoshes up to the stage with my high heels in them, and I'll probably take those off, but I'm going to sing in my high heels, mud or no mud.
And will you get a chance to see other acts when you're there?
I don't know how that's going to be. I'd love to be able to, but chances are we'll just be there during the time that it's time for our show and do that and go. I wish I'd had the time to, you know, I don't want anybody to think I'm just an old stick in the mud, but I would love to do it if I could. Working 9 to 5, 9 to 5.
Well, I'm not sure anyone would call Dolly Parton a stick in the mud, would they? Now, if she does choose to hang around to watch who's after her on the pyramid stage, she can see Ed Sheeran. Now, he is, would you believe this, 45 years her junior. Now, here's what he had to say about coping with the Glastonbury weather.
The last time I played Glastonbury, we did 12 shows in 3 days, and I did the welly thing, and I lost a Converse in the mud somewhere, walked around with the one Converse and a sock for a while. Like, that was such a bad day. Oh God. And then so I've done the festival thing, I've done the Grafton, the small independent festivals, I've done all of them, and now I'm at a point where you can sit in a trailer and stay in a hotel, and
yeah,
you know, I enjoy that. I enjoy showers, I enjoy being clean.
I'll say something. Well, Alex has joined me now. You were just saying that you brought your Converse with you, yeah, but you've
stuck... They
have
not been worn at once. No. I've got the wellies on. Yep. I did actually arrive in a bit hot in my car, but I very quickly realised that the weather was on the chain. So, yeah, it's been good. But it is just a Glastonbury festival. If you come here, you've got to be prepared for all types of weather.
Absolutely. Now, I was just saying, my hands are freezing. It is quite chilly now,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, you know what? It's funny the difference, obviously, once the clouds are going over, it's, you know, it just changes. The temperatures drop by 2 or 3 degrees, and it is a little bit cold now. Temperatures will start to drop as we go through tonight.
How's it looking for the weekend then, very quickly?
All weekend, well, we've still got that weather warning in place issued by the Met Office for these heavy, possibly thundery showers through tomorrow as well. So if you are going to be about across all parts of the region, do prepare for this. In between, there'll be some bright and sunny spells. Let's take a look at the forecast for this weekend.
ITV West Country weather, sponsored by BMI Regional Airlines and Bristol Airport.
Well, here at the moment, we are literally just on the edge of a thunderstorm off to my left there. Things should die down as we go through the next couple of hours. Most parts are becoming dry, perhaps the odd light shower from time to time. The temperature will be mild in towns and cities, but out in the countryside on farms, it will be feeling a fair bit cooler, just as it is at the moment. Now, by tomorrow, we are going to see those showers redeveloping, perhaps dry at first, but some of those showers will become quite widespread and locally quite heavy, and they are going to last into the afternoon as well. The possibility that one or two of them could turn on the thundery side, and if you do catch one of these showers, you certainly will know about it, because we are going to have fairly light winds, so they are going to be moving through pretty slowly indeed. Obviously, where the showers do crop up, temperatures will take a bit of a dip, so it will feel quite cool at times, so make sure you throw on that extra layer. Then for the rest of the weekend, well, things aren't looking too bad. A small ridge of high pressure moves in on Sunday, so that's going to be the better day to make the most of. So we'll have some bright and sunny spells, but also a few showers developing. And then into next week, it is a slightly quieter picture. Showers never really too far away. The good news is that the pollen levels will be changing over the coming day, so good news for hay fever sufferers. Let's take a look at the pollen count right now.
Sponsored by BMI Regional Airlines and Bristol Airport.
The Pollen Count, sponsored by Checkatrade.com.
Checkatrade, Checkatrade.com.
The positive side to this showery weather is that it will wash away some of the pollen from the air down to moderate levels tomorrow, and that legacy will continue into next week, the readings generally remaining at moderate.
Alex, thanks very much indeed. Well, that is just about all from us at the Glastonbury Festival 2014. We will, of course, have plenty more on our late news and on our bulletins throughout the weekend, as well as updates on our website. Now, we'll leave you with some pictures of the first day of the Glastonbury Festival. Now, I hope I'm not going to need this weekend, but it looks like I might this evening as the storm moves in. From all of us here, have a very good weekend. Bye-bye.